This is the neighborhood I live in. It's in the inner city of Amsterdam. And I was wondering, why do I like this neighborhood so much? And it is not about the picture you see here, which is a sort of perfect picture any tourist could have made. I think the secret of it is in what's behind this block. Behind this block is this. Something you would not expect. A surprising place, but for me also very much a place of opportunity, a place where people can do other things, the unexpected. And that's why I like this area so much. And I also think I like it so much because it's so different from the area I was raised in. I was raised in a suburb like this, to the north of Amsterdam, like many people of you of my age probably. Everybody moved out of the city in the 70s and 80s and lived in these very dull suburbs where there was nothing happening. Really was not my place to live in. But we were not able to make the city as I showed you before. I think we made these standard housing complexes for the last 50 years, like this in the 60s, this in the 70s and 80s. I didn't even know that this could be made in Holland. It doesn't seem like a Dutch building area. So when did we lose the ability to make real cities, to make this city that consists of what everybody is looking for in a city? The mix of people, the mix of views, the possibility to make your own city. And of course, I'm not the first one who thinks about this. Already years ago, Jane Jacobs thought about what makes city an interesting place to be. And she said it's mainly about the people. The people should create the city. And I think we were able to do that also in Holland. This is the Canal Belt, you probably all know. And this area was created 400 years ago, and it is still one of the strongest areas we can offer. And I think it is a combination of factors that makes it such a strong area. The first is, of course, the place where it is made and the fact that they dig these canals, which was not because it was so nice and pretty, but really because of a functional reason, because it was a very wet soil and they needed to get rid of the water. But I think the most interesting thing is that it was not built in one go, like the suburbs I showed you before, but it was really built step by step. People could buy a plot, they could fill it in as they liked, it was not fixed how big a plot should be, they could make whatever they wanted to make within the main structure of the canals. And always when I see this photo, it's a painting, you can see that it was made like that. So what we know is this final image. But the fact that it was made plot by plot makes it such a rich city. And it's also interesting because up to today, every building can change. It started as a housing, one house for a rich family, then it became an office, some have become a hotel. It still has the flexibility and the possibility to let people live and do what they are interested in the area. So what do we learn from the Canal Belt? I think there are four things that are important for each city when you develop it. It has to do with the people. What do people want? What do they like? What do they want to achieve in a city? It's about the place, the special abilities of the place, the possibilities, the history. It's about showing opportunities and possibilities for people. And that all together can create a public value that is much more than just summing up the little parts of it. And with these ideas, we started to work on the island of Oostenburg, we just spoke about, which is in the inner city of Amsterdam. And the fact that it's not such a known place has to do with that it was an industrial area for many ages. There were big ships built there, there were big machines made there. So it's a bit of a hidden place. And when you look at this photo, you can see the central station is a bit more to the east. So it is really very close to the inner city, but a bit of an unknown place. So when we started to work on this area, we thought it's not about making, building just houses. It is how do you create a city vibe? And I think a city doesn't start with building bricks, but it starts with the people. So the first thing to make this work is to let people discover the place, simply opening the gates. An entrepreneur who wanted to do a city beach there, opening a restaurant, that's what started the place to become more than just an area where you could live. So that's the first element. Secondly, there is of course this rich history of the island with elements that are interesting, that people wonder what happened on this island before, and that's also a very rich element to use in the development. So then we had to draw something, and actually we thought it's not us drawing a plan is not what's important. It's about people, what they want to do in this area. So what we did is we drew this cartoon-like drawing, which is more showing what are the possibilities within this area. What would you like? What would your dream be to realize on the island of Oostenburg? Do you consider yourself living in one of these apartments on the waterside? Do you want to start your own business on this island? What do people want to make here? That is what will form the city, not what we as planners think of it. And the interesting thing is that this really works, that lots of people are coming to the island considering, what could I do here? What could I bring to this neighborhood? And even still, there's not one building built yet. There is already a vibe of people who want to discover and make this area together. And I think that that vibe creates the public value of the area. The streets, the liveliness on the streets, the fact that it will become an area that it's not just visited by people who live there or should be there, but people who are just visiting and exploring the possibilities of the city. That's what makes this a rich area. So for me, I think the combination of these four elements is very vital to making a city. And I think that even that suburb that I grew up in the 70s, should be able to be transformed in a way that fits this wondering, this what would you like to do in your city? What can you make? What would you like to be in a city? So the most important thing for this development is, I think, that we are all participants in the spontaneous city. That a spontaneous city is created by the people, and that we all get the opportunity to be part of city makers. Thank you.